أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
وستكون المذاكرة على كتاب من كتب أهل العلم، وهو كتاب ثلاثة الأصول لشيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى.
We will go through the book أصول الثلاثة, the three fundamental principles, which is by Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, and we will go through it and explain the book.
وهذا الكتاب يهتم بما يجب على كل مسلم ومسلمة أن يتعلمه من دين الله عز وجل.
This book goes through that which is obligatory upon every Muslim man and woman to learn from the deen of Allah عز وجل.
وخاصة ما يحقق معنى لا إله إلا الله.
And especially we will consider and concentrate upon the oneness of Allah عز وجل and the oneness of Allah عز وجل in His worship.
وقد اعتمد مؤلفه عليه رحمة الله عز وجل على أدلة الكتاب والسنة.
The author of the book, he has depended and relied upon the evidences of the Quran and the Sunnah whilst writing this book and authorizing this book.
والله تعالى إنما أمرنا باتباع الكتاب والسنة.
And this is also coincides with that which Allah Azza wa Jal commands us to do, and that is to follow the evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah.
فهو الذي يقول أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول.
And Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, and be obedient to Allah Azza wa Jal, and be obedient to His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
وقال فإن تنازعتم في شيء فردوه إلى الله وإلى الرسول.
And Allah Azza wa Jal says that if you were to differ in something and have confliction over something, then come back and turn to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
فديننا نأخذه من كلام الله ومن كلام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Our deen, our religion, we take it from two sources, and the first source is the Quran, and the second source is the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وليس هناك حجة إلا كلام الله وكلام الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And there is nothing else of evidence that one can take other than the book of Allah Azza wa Jal and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
ثم اعلموا أن الله عز وجل خلقنا لغاية عظيمة.
Know the fact that Allah Azza wa Jal has created us for a great purpose.
أن نعبد الله وحده.
And that is that we worship Allah Azza wa Jal alone without any partners.
يقول الله تعالى وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran that I did not create man nor the jinn except for the purpose of worshiping me alone.
وهذا هو الذي شرف الله به البشر.
And this is the honor that Allah Azza wa Jal granted to mankind.
وإلا فيكون حالهم كحال البهائم.
If that would not be the case that Allah Azza wa Jal has honored us with the worship, then we would have been like the animals.
فالله خلق البشر لكي يعبدوه.
So Allah Azza wa Jal has created the human beings so that they could worship Allah Azza wa Jal alone.
ما خلقهم للعب.
Allah Azza wa Jal did not create us so we could play.
ما خلقهم للشرب والأكل.
Allah Azza wa Jal did not create us so that we could eat and drink on this earth.
وإنما خلقهم الله لكي يعبد عز وجل.
Rather, Allah Azza wa Jal has only created us for the purpose that we worship Him alone without any partners.
وأباح لنا أن نعمر الأرض.
And Allah Azza wa Jal has permitted for us that we live upon this earth.
وأن نعمل فيها.
And we work upon this earth.
وأن نأكل الحلال.
And we eat that which is halal.
ولكن لا نفرط في عبادة الله.
But we do not become we do not slack in the worship of Allah Azza wa Jal.
فالله بذلك أمر كل البشر.
In that case, Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded all of mankind.
لماذا?
Why is that?
لأنه هو الذي خلقنا.
Because Allah Azza wa Jal is the one to create us.
وعندما خلقنا أراد منا أن نعبده.
And when He created us, the purpose of our creation was the fact that we worship Him alone.
ولذلك نادى كل الناس.
And that is the reason Allah Azza wa Jal called out to all the people.
ليس فقط المسلمون.
Not only just the Muslims.
بل نادى كل الناس.
Rather, He called out to everyone.
قال يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم.
And Allah Azza wa Jal called upon everyone, Muslims, non-Muslims, and He said, O people, worship Allah Azza wa Jal alone.
من هو ربنا?
Who is our Rabb? Who is our Lord?
الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
He is the one that created you and those before you so that you may attain piety.
فإذا لابد علينا أن نعرف هذه الحقيقة.
And it's very, very important the fact that we understand this reality.
وكلنا يعرف بأن لا إله إلا الله هي أصل الإسلام.
And every one of us knows the fact that the basic principle or the main principle of Islam is لا إله إلا الله, that there is no God worthy of worship except from Allah.
هي باب الإسلام. هي باب الإسلام.
And this is a door of Islam.
لا يدخل الإسلام إلا عن طريقه.
And no one can enter into Islam except that he accepts this.
تقول لا إله إلا الله تدخل الإسلام.
You say لا إله إلا الله, there is no one worthy of worship, you enter into Islam.
تخالف لا إله إلا الله تخرج من الإسلام.
And if you go against لا إله إلا الله and its principles, then you move away from Islam.
فهي كلمة عظيمة.
So it's a word that which is great and magnitude.
وهي مفتاح الجنة.
And it is a key to paradise.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said,
من كان آخر كلامه من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة.
That whosever last words from this word is, from this world is لا إله إلا الله, that there is no God worthy of worship except from Allah, then he shall enter into Jannah.
ولما بعث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم معاذا إلى اليمن.
And when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sent Mu'adh ibn Jabal to Yemen,
قال له,
he said to him,
فليكن أول ما تدعوهم إليه شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله.
Let it be, O Mu'adh, that the first thing that you call the people to is that they worship no one other than Allah عز وجل.
فإذا نحن جميعا من أهل لا إله إلا الله.
So all of us are from the people of لا إله إلا الله.
أحد منكم يخالف في هذا؟
Does anyone differ in that?
الجواب لا.
And the answer is no.
قطعا لا.
Never.
طيب. ما هي لا إله إلا الله؟
What is لا إله إلا الله؟
ما معناها؟
What's the meaning of it؟
ما شروطها؟
What's its conditions؟
ما أركانها؟
What's its pillars؟
ما حقوقها علينا؟
What's its rights؟
ما الذي يضر بها وينقضها؟
Who is the one that benefits from it or harms from it?
إذا كنتم تعرفون ذلك فأنتم تعرفون لا إله.
And whoever understands that, he would understand لا إله إلا الله.
ولا بد على أهل لا إله إلا الله أن يعرفوا هذه الأمور.
And the ones who claim that they say لا إله إلا الله, it's a must the fact that they know these things.
حتى يكونوا من أهلها.
So that you could be from its people.
وهذا الكتاب الذي معنا كتاب ثلاثة الأصول.
And this book that we have, the three principles,
يبين لنا هذه الأمور.
Will clarify and bring clarity within these issues.
ويعلمنا لا إله إلا الله.
And it will teach us what لا إله إلا الله means.
ومعنى أن محمد رسول الله.
And what Muhammad صلى الله what I bear witness to the fact that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the last messenger and what that means.
فيجب علينا جميعا رجالا ونساء.
And it's upon everyone from men and women.
أن نتعلم هذا الأمر.
That we learn these things.
وخاصة الذي يتعلق بالتوحيد والعقيدة.
And especially that which is related to the oneness of Allah عز وجل and that which is related to your creed, that you learn it.
لأن الدين لا يقوم إلا عليها.
Because a person's religion is not established without it.
فمجرد حب الدين والانتساب للدين لا يكفي.
Just so the fact that you love the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal, the religion of Allah Azza wa Jal, and that which is consisted within it is not enough for a person.
لأن هناك من الناس من ينتسب إلى الإسلام.
There are many people that connect themselves to Islam.
ويزعم أنه يحب الإسلام.
And they also claim the fact that they love Islam.
وهو يسيء للإسلام.
But rather they do bad towards Islam.
ويخالف الإسلام.
And they go against Islam.
ولا يعرف الإسلام.
And they don't understand Islam.
لا بد أن نتعلم ما هو الإسلام.
So it's a must the fact that we learn what Islam is.
يقول الله تعالى في سورة الكهف.
And Allah عز وجل says in Surah Al-Kahf.
قل هل ننبئكم بالأخسرين أعمالا.
Say, should I not let you know of that which is the lowest of actions?
الذين ضل سعيهم في الحياة الدنيا وهم يحسبون أنهم يحسنون صنعا.
They are the ones who lived upon this earth thinking the fact that they did good, rather they did the opposite.
فهناك من الناس من يظن بأنه على خير.
So there are people amongst this world that you will find that they think that they do good.
وأنه يعمل صالحا.
And they are doing righteous.
ولكن إذا عرضنا عمله على الإسلام فإذا هو قد خالف الإسلام.
But rather when we weigh their actions against Islam, we understand that they've gone against it.
فمجرد النية والغاية لا تكفي.
So just to have your intention and your goal is not enough.
لا بد أن يكون العمل سليما على سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
It's a must that your actions and your sayings are complete and upon the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
تسمعون في سورة الغاشية.
Do you hear of سورة الغاشية؟
وجوه يومئذ خاشعة.
And their faces will be they will have faces that which are fearful.
تبكي.
And they will be crying.
عاملة ناصبة تعمل.
And they used to work and they used to do good.
أين هي؟
Where is it?
تصلى نار الحامية.
In the hellfire, dragged into the hellfire.
لأنهم يعبدون الله بجهل.
Because they used to worship Allah عز وجل with ignorance.
لا يعبدون الله بعلم.
Then they did not worship Allah عز وجل with knowledge and evidence.
والله تعالى لا يعبد بالجهل.
And Allah عز وجل is not worshipped with ignorance, rather He's worshipped with evidence.
وإنما نعبده بالعلم.
And rather we worship Him in knowledge and evidence.
فتعلم التوحيد.
So you should learn what the tawheed and oneness of Allah means.
تعلم الصلاة.
And you should learn what salah and establishing the prayer means.
تعلم الدين كله.
So you should learn the complete religion.
ليس صعبا.
And it's not very difficult.
فالله تعالى قال عن القرآن.
Allah عز وجل says in the Quran.
الذي هو مصدر العلم.
And this is the original and the basis of all knowledge.
وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مَنْ مُدَّكِرٍ.
And we have made the Quran easy upon the people. Is there anyone that ponders over it?
فَلَا يَضْحَكْ عَلَيْكَ الشَّيْطَانُ.
So let not the shaitan laugh upon you.
ويخدعك.
And play with you.
ويقول بأنه صعب.
And tell you the fact that it's difficult.
ولن تفهم.
And the fact that you won't understand.
أبداً.
Never say that to yourself.
هو سهل.
It's very easy.
القدر الواجب.
What's must upon you.
سهل.
Is the fact that it's easy.
يأتي أعرابي إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And a Bedouin comes to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فيخبره بالإيمان.
And he tells him of إيمان.
يخبره بالصلاة.
And he tells him of صلاة.
يخبره بالصوم.
And he tells him about fasting.
يخبره بالزكاة.
And he tells him about giving charity.
ثم يقول الأعرابي.
And then the Bedouin says to him.
وهو بدوي لا يعيش في المدينة.
And he's a Bedouin, he doesn't know what a city looks like.
هل علي غيرها؟
Is there anything else upon me that I should do?
يقول لا.
There's nothing else that you should do, said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يقول والله لا أزيد عليها حتى أموت فيخرج.
And the Bedouin said that I will never increase more than that which you have given to me, O Prophet of Allah, and he left.
فيقول النبي عليه السلام.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
أفلح إن صدق يعني إن صدق في قوله سيدخل الجنة.
If this person is truthful, then he will be successful.
في مجلس واحد.
In one sitting.
تعلم الإسلام.
He learned Islam.
فأنت بإمكانك أن تتعلم الإسلام.
And also with you is also possible the fact that you understand and learn Islam.
والحمد لله اليوم الدروس كثيرة.
And alhamdulillah today with the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla we have many lessons.
فإياك أن تتعبد لله بدون علم.
And be warned the fact that you don't worship Allah Azza wa Jalla without knowledge.
اسأل.
Ask.
تعلم.
And learn.
لا تستحي.
And don't be shy.
لن تعبد الله وتعرف الدين وأنت تستحي عن السؤال.
You will never learn the deen of Allah عز وجل and learn what to do if you are shy.
في القرآن الكريم ويسألونك 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 يسأل الصحابة كانوا يسألون النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And in the Quran we see the fact that the Allah عز وجل mentions and they ask you, O Prophet of Allah, they ask you, O Prophet of Allah. And we learn the fact that the companions always used to ask in regards to their affairs to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
والله تعالى يقول للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقل ربي زدني علما.
And Allah عز وجل would say to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and say, O Muhammad, increase. Say, O Muhammad, ask Allah عز وجل to increase in your knowledge.
وأنتم كذلك.
And you could do the same.
قولوا ربي زدنا علما.
And say to Allah عز وجل, O Allah, increase me in my knowledge.
واحضروا الدروس.
And memorize your lessons.
استمعوا الخطب.
And listen to the sermons.
اسمعوا الفتاوى.
And listen to the rulings.
من أهل العلم أهل السنة.
From the people of knowledge and the people of sunnah.
الذين يبينون سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The ones who clarify and put forward to you clearly the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وهذا الكلام مقدمة لشرح كتاب ثلاثة الأصول للشيخ محمد بن عبد الوهاب.
And this is the introduction to the book أصول الثلاثة, the three principles that we will be going through.
وهذا الكلام عندما ندرسه ونتعلمه.
And these words when we will learn them and we will teach them.
ليس لأنه كلام هذا الرجل.
It's not the fact that because these are the words of this man.
هو كلام الله عز وجل.
All of these are the words of Allah عز وجل that he mentions.
وكلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And these are the words of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وهو جمعها لنا في كتاب.
And all he's done is he's gathered it in one book.
فما هي الأصول الثلاثة؟
So what is the three principles?
من ربك؟
Who is your Lord?
من نبيك؟
Who is your Prophet?
ما دينك؟
And what is your religion?
هذه هي الأصول الثلاثة.
These are the three principles.
هذا ليس كلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب.
This is not the words of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab.
هذا كلام محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
These are the words of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أخبرنا بأن الإنسان في قبره يسأل عن ثلاث.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us the fact that the person when he goes to his grave he will be asked of three questions.
من ربك؟
Who is your Lord?
ما دينك؟
What's your religion?
من نبيك؟
And who is your Prophet?
هذه الثلاث.
And these three.
هي العلوم الواجبة.
And these are the this is the knowledge that's obligatory and a must upon everyone.
لا يجب عليك من العلوم في الدنيا إلا هذه الثلاث.
There's not necessary for you to learn any other knowledge except from these three principles.
والدليل أن الله تعالى سألنا عنها في القبر.
And what's and the evidence for that is the hadith that we've just mentioned of the qabr.
فإذا نتعلم العلم بما جاء في الكتاب والسنة.
So from there we take the fact that we learn the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal from that which Allah Azza wa Jal has given to us from the Quran and the Sunnah and the practice and the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
والإمام محمد بن عبد الوهاب إنما هو جمع هذه الأمور.
And Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he has gathered all of these principles in this book.
وهي موجودة في كتاب الله.
And they're also, you'll find them in the book of Allah.
وفي سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And you also find them in the ahadith and the traditions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وقد وعدنا هو المؤلف هنا وعدنا بوعد.
And the author has promised us one promise.
قال وأدلتها أي أنني لن أذكر في كتاب هذا شيء لن أذكر شيئا إلا بالدليل.
The fact that everything I mention in this book will have evidence with it.
فإننا نحن لا نتبع الإنسان إلا بالدليل.
And so, hence, we do not follow anyone except the fact that he has evidence.
إذا كان عن الله وعن رسول الله قبلناه.
If it's from Allah and it's from the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, we will accept it.
وإذا كان من كلامك أنت فلسنا مجبرين ولسنا ملزمين بأن نقبله.
And if it's from yourself or myself, then we're not obligated to follow that.
فهنا رحمه الله تعالى جاء بكل شيء بدليله كلما ذكر أمرا قال والدليل قوله تعالى والدليل قوله تعالى.
And hence we see the author the fact that every point he will mention he will give you evidence for it.
نعم استعمل الله بسم الله
ونترجم
جيد كان قرأت ترجمة أحسن كلامه
نقرأ الكلام ونشرح
طيب لا أقرأ كلامه وأنا سأشرح وترجم شرحي
نترجم الشرح
شرحي أنا نعم
okay. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اعلم رحمك الله أنه يجب علينا تعلم أربع مسائل الأولى العلم وهو معرفة الله ومعرفة نبيه ومعرفة دين الإسلام بالأدلة الثانية العمل به الثالثة الدعوة إليه الرابعة الصبر على الأذى فيه والدليل قوله تعالى والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.
بدأ المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى كتابه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
The مؤلف or the author of the book has started his book with the name of Allah عز وجل and he says in the name of Allah عز وجل the most beneficent, the most merciful.
والبدء ببسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لطلب البركة من الله.
And we always start in the name of Allah عز وجل. Whenever you wish to start anything, you start in the name of Allah عز وجل, invoking in Allah and asking of His blessings in that which you will be doing.
ولذلك نحن نبدأ بها عند قراءة القرآن.
And this is why we started and we start in the name of Allah عز وجل when we wish to recite the Quran.
نقولها عند الطعام.
And we also say it upon when we want to eat our food.
عند دخول المسجد.
And when we want to enter the masjid, we also mention the name of Allah.
إذا كتبنا الرسائل.
And when we write letters to anyone, we also start in the name of Allah.
فنبدأ ببسم الله في كل أعمالنا.
So in every action, one should start in the name of Allah عز وجل.
حتى يبارك الله عز وجل فيها.
So that may Allah عز وجل bless you within your action.
ثم قال اعلم رحمك الله.
And the author said, No, may Allah عز وجل have mercy upon you.
دع لك.
He has called you to this call.
وهذا هو الواجب.
And this is what the obligatory action is.
أن نتلطف للناس.
The fact that we are soft with the people, as the author said, oh no, may Allah Azza wa Jal have mercy on you.
ومن التلطف للناس الدعاء لهم.
And how to be soft towards people is to give them dua, that always supplicate for them.
أخي بارك الله فيك.
Oh my brother, may Allah Azza wa Jal bless within you.
جزاك الله خيرا.
May Allah Azza wa Jal reward you.
وفقك الله.
May Allah Azza wa Jal be with you, help you.
إذا أردت أن تتكلم مع شخص من إخوانك فادع له بالخير.
Whenever you wish to talk to your brother, a brother in Islam, you always make dua for him.
لأنك إذا دعوت له بالخير فإنك تكرمه.
Whenever you meet him and you make dua for him and you give him salam and you give him dua and so forth, this is an honor that you give him.
وتحسن إليه.
And you're doing good towards him.
والنفوس تحب من أحسن إليها.
And we will find the fact that the souls love those people who show them mercy.
فيصغي لك ويسمع كلامك.
So he will hence listen to you.
فهنا المؤلف قال اعلم رحمك الله.
And then the author says, no, may Allah Azza wa Jal have mercy on you.
أنه يجب علينا تعلم أربع مسائل.
That it is a must upon you that you learn four things.
المسألة الأمر الأول العلم.
The first thing that you should learn is knowledge.
دين الإسلام قائم على العلم.
All of the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal stands upon knowledge.
يجب أن تتعلم.
It's a must the fact that you learn it.
أي علم من هذا؟
Which knowledge are we talking about? What knowledge is this?
كل العلوم.
Every knowledge in the world?
لا.
That's not the case.
ثلاثة علوم.
Three types of knowledge.
اعلم من هو ربك.
Know who is your Lord. That's number one.
لا بد أن تعرف الله.
It's a must the fact that you know who are you worshipping.
وحق الله عليك.
What's Allah's rights?
كيف تعبد الله?
How do you worship Allah?
وأنت لا تعرفه.
And how could you do that if you don't know Him?
لا بد أن تعرف الله عز وجل.
So it's a must the fact that you understand and you know Allah عز وجل.
ولذلك كفار قريش أو المشركون لما كفروا بالله عز وجل لماذا كفروا بالله?
And the disbelievers of Quraysh when they committed kufr with Allah, disbelief with Allah, why did they do that?
ما عرفوا الله.
Because he did not understand Allah.
يقول الله تعالى.
Allah عز وجل says.
وما قدر الله حق قدره أي ما عرف الله حق معرفته.
Because Allah عز وجل says it's due to the fact that they did not understand Allah عز وجل as they should have.
أما أنت أيها المسلم.
And as for you, O Muslims.
تعرف بأن الله ربك.
You know the fact that Allah is your Lord.
وأنه الذي خلقك.
And He is the one who created you.
وشق سمعك وبصرك.
And He is the one who gave you hearing and sight.
وأن اسمه الله. وأن اسمه الله.
And His name is Allah عز وجل.
أي المعبود.
And He is the one to be worshipped.
وأنه الرحمن والرحيم.
And He is all merciful.
والسميع والعليم.
And He is all hearing and all knowing.
والقوي.
And He is all powerful.
وأسماء الله كثيرة.
And Allah عز وجل's names are many.
أكثر من 99 اسم.
More than 99 names.
فكلما عرفت اسما من أسماء الله.
Every time you learn the names of Allah عز وجل and His attributes.
أنت تقترب أكثر إلى الله.
You will get closer to Allah عز وجل.
وتخاف من الله عز وجل.
And you will increase in your piety and fear of Allah عز وجل.
فلا بد أن نعرف الله.
So it's a must the fact that you understand and know Allah Azza wa Jalla.
وأن نعرف محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Secondly, that you know the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
نطلب سنته.
And you should seek his sunnah, what it is.
كيف يصلي؟
How did he pray?
كيف يصوم؟
How did he fast?
كيف يزكي؟
How would he praise?
كيف ينام؟
How he would sleep?
كيف يأكل؟
How he would eat?
كيف يشرب؟
How he would drink?
هذا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And this is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ما اسمه؟
What's his name?
أين بلده?
Where did he stay?
كم عمره?
What's his age?
اعرف هذه الأمور عن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
You should know these things about your Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وتطيع كل أوامره.
And you should be obedient in everything that he gives you and says to you.
وتجتنب عن كل ما نهاك عنه.
And you should keep away from everything that which is forbidden.
فالله سيسألك في القبر عنه.
For Allah Azza wa Jalla will ask you in regards to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the grave.
فلا بد أن تعرف هذا اليوم.
So it's a must the fact that you understand that day is to come.
حتى تجيب عن هذا السؤال.
So the fact that you could answer these questions.
أنت مسلم.
And you're a Muslim.
أي مستسلم.
I you've submitted yourself to Allah.
مستسلم لله عز وجل.
You've submitted yourself to Allah's religion.
بماذا?
Why and with what?
أنت مسلم بالصلاة.
And you're a Muslim in within your prayer.
كيف أصلي?
How do you pray?
تعلم الصلاة.
Learn how to pray.
كيف أزكي?
How do you give zakat?
تعلم الزكاة.
And learn how to give zakat.
لا بد قبل أن تعمل بالعلم.
Before you do any actions,
لا تقدم على العمل إلا بالعلم أولا.
Make sure of the fact that you don't act upon anything except that you have knowledge of it, of how to do it.
إذا يسر الله عز وجل لك الحج والعمرة نسأل الله أن ييسر للجميع ذلك.
Inshallah, if Allah Azza wa Jal makes it easy for you, the fact that you go for Hajj and Umrah, and may Allah Azza wa Jal make that easy for you.
وبشروك بأنك سوف تحج هذا العام. بشروك. أعطوك بشارة بأنك سوف تحج هذا العام.
Inshallah, we give you glad tidings that Inshallah, with the will of Allah, you will go to Hajj this year.
ماذا تصنع؟
What will you do?
أنت ستؤدي عبادة.
You will carry out certain acts of عبادة or not.
لابد قبل أن أذهب أتعلم.
And it's a must the fact that you learn how to do that.
فلابد إذا من العلم قبل العمل.
So it's a must the fact that you have knowledge before you act upon the principles of Hajj.
فقال الأولى العلم.
So the first thing is knowledge.
ثم العمل بالعلم.
Then you act upon the knowledge.
لا يجوز للمسلم أن يتعلم ولا يعمل.
And it's not permissible for the person the fact that he acts upon something without any knowledge.
فكلما تعلمنا شيء يجب أن نعمل به.
So every time you learn something, it's a must the fact that you act upon it.
لأنك إذا تعلمت ولم تعمل بالعلم فإن هذا العلم حجة عليك عند الله عز وجل.
So for if you were to have the knowledge and you were to understand the deen of Allah عز وجل and you did not act upon it, then it will stand against you on the day of judgment.
لأن الناس مع العلم والعمل على ثلاثة على أربعة أقسام.
Know the fact that people with knowledge and actions are upon three categories.
هذه الأقسام الثلاثة أحسن بنص آية الفاتحة سورة الفاتحة. الناس في العلم والعمل على ثلاثة أقسام.
So when it comes to your knowledge and actions, people are upon three categories.
قوم يعملون يعلمون ويعملون.
There is a nation that understands knowledge and they act upon it.
هؤلاء هم الذين أنعم الله عليهم.
They are the ones Allah عز وجل will bless.
قال صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم.
As Allah عز وجل says, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم and the path upon which we have blessed.
من هم الذين أنعم الله عليهم?
Who are the ones that Allah عز وجل has blessed?
هم الذين علموا ثم عملوا.
They are the ones that understood knowledge, learnt knowledge, and then acted upon it.
غير المغضوب عليهم.
And then Allah عز وجل says, not the path of those who have earned your anger.
من المغضوب عليهم?
Who are the ones that earned Allah's anger?
هم الذين عندهم علم ولكن لم يعملوا.
They are the ones who have knowledge, understand knowledge, but did not act upon it.
ولا الضالين.
ولا الضالين. Neither the path of those who have gone astray.
من هم الضالون?
Who are the ones who have gone astray?
هم الذين يعملون ولكن بدون علم.
They are the ones who act upon something but without knowledge, without having any solid evidence.
فماذا تختار أنت?
What will you choose?
أن تكون من المغضوب عليهم?
Do you want to be from the ones who earned Allah's anger?
أو تكون من الضالين?
Or you want to be from the ones who have gone astray?
أو من المنعم عليهم?
Or the ones that have been blessed by Allah عز وجل?
إذا كنت تريد أن تكون من المنعم عليهم?
If you wish to be from amongst those whom Allah عز وجل has blessed,
فعلم.
Then learn.
ثم اعمل.
And then act upon it.
ولا يتخلف العلم عن العمل.
And make sure of the fact that you do not act without knowledge.
إذا تعلمنا في أنفسنا
and if we were to learn for ourselves
وعملنا بالعمل
and we act upon it
الإسلام دين جماعة
then know the fact that our religion is a religion of community
ندعو إليه
then we call others to it
نحن لا نحب الخير لأنفسنا فقط
we're not people that are selfless the fact that we want خير and good for ourselves only
نحب الخير لأنفسنا وللعالمين أجمعين.
Or rather, the Muslims are such people that they want good for themselves and they give it to other people also and the rest of the world.
لأن الله تعالى بعث محمدا للعالمين.
Because the Prophet Allah عز وجل sent Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to the whole world.
رحمة للعالمين.
And he was a mercy to the whole world.
فكذلك نحن نكون.
And just like that, we should be also.
ندعو إلى الله.
We should call to Allah عز وجل.
من الذي يدعو إلى الله?
Who is the one who calls to Allah?
الشيخ فقط.
Is it only the sheikh?
أو الخطيب?
Or the person who gives a sermon?
أو المعلم?
Or the teacher?
لا.
It's not him.
كلنا.
Everyone.
أنا وأنت.
Me and you both.
والرجل والمرأة.
And man and woman, everyone should call.
الذي تتعلمه في الصباح.
And that which you have learnt in the morning.
علمه في الليل.
You should teach it in the night.
لا تزيد.
And you should not increase more than that.
بقدر ما تعلم تعلم.
Whatever you have learned and however much you have learned, then you teach that much also.
عرفت لا إله إلا الله.
If you have understood لا إله إلا الله,
أخبر زوجتك.
Then tell your wife.
أخبر أبنائك.
Tell your children.
هنا تكون أنت داعي إلى الله.
And like that you will be a person who calls and preaches to Allah Azza wa Jal.
وتكون على سبيل محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And you'll be upon the path of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
عرفت كيفية الصلاة؟
Did you understand how to pray?
علمك الشيخ هنا الصلاة كيف تصلي؟
Did the Sheikh not teach you how to pray صلاة؟
مباشرة أنت الآن داعية.
Now it's a case upon you the fact that you've learned and now you go and teach other people.
علم زوجتك.
And then you teach your wife.
علم أبنائك.
Then you teach your children.
علم صديقك.
And you teach your friends.
هنا تكون تابع للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And just like that, you will be with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يقول الله تعالى.
Allah عز وجل says.
قل يعني يا محمد.
Say O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قل هذه سبيلي.
This is my path.
هذه طريقي.
This is my way.
ما هي؟
What is it?
أدعو إلى الله.
That I call to Allah.
لوحده.
On his own.
لا. قال أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة أي على علم.
I will call upon with wisdom and knowledge.
وليس لوحده.
Not by himself.
أنا.
Me.
ومن اتبعني.
And those who follow me.
وأنتم أتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And you are the followers of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فادعوا إلى الله.
So call to Allah.
بشرط.
With a condition.
على بصيرة.
Make sure it's upon knowledge.
لا تتكلم بغير علم.
Make sure you don't talk without knowledge.
تكلم فقط بالذي تعلمت.
Only talk upon that which you have knowledge of.
الذي لا تعرفه.
And that which you don't know.
لا تقول على الله بغير علم.
And don't say things that are against Allah عز وجل without knowledge.
فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
Then ask the people of the knowledge if you don't know.
أما إن كنتم تعلمون.
And if you were to know.
فعلموا.
Then teach the people.
واعملوا.
And act upon it yourself.
فإذا نتعلم في أنفسنا.
So we learn. Within ourselves,
ونعمل,
and we act upon it,
وندعو إلى الله,
and we also call others to this knowledge.
الرابع,
and what's number four?
الصبر,
that we are patient.
الصبر أين الصبر?
What's صبر? So what's patience? And how do we be patient?
نصبر على التعلم.
We have to be patient upon learning the knowledge in the first place.
أنتم الآن جلوس تعبتم من الجلوس.
So at the moment you're trying to learn something and you're being patient. You're sitting down, are you not?
اصبروا.
So you be patient.
قراءة كتاب.
Reading a book.
تحتاج إلى صبر.
It needs patience.
حضور الدرس.
Coming to a lesson.
يحتاج إلى صبر.
Needs patience.
الخطبة. يحتاج إلى صبر.
And sitting in the khutbah requires patience.
سماع محاضرة. يحتاج إلى صبر.
Listening to a lecture requires patience.
ختم القرآن يحتاج إلى صبر.
To finish the Quran requires patience.
الحفظ يحتاج إلى صبر.
To memorize also requires patience.
إذن العلم يحتاج إلى صبر.
So knowledge requires the fact that you be patient.
العمل به.
An action upon your knowledge.
الصلاة.
Your salah, your prayer.
تحتاج إلى صبر.
Also requires that you're patient.
خمس فروض تأتي وتصلي وتقوم وتقعد. تحتاج إلى صبر.
Five times a day that you come in, you stand up, you sit down, you leave and so forth. Five times a day requires the fact that the person is patient.
الصوم.
And just like that, fasting.
جوع.
You're going to be hungry.
وضمع.
You're going to feel thirsty.
اصبر.
You've got to be patient.
الزكاة.
Also giving money in the way of Allah.
تخرج المال المحبوب لنفسك تخرجه.
So that which you love of wealth, you're going to take it out and give it to somebody else.
اصبر.
You've got to be patient on that too.
الحج والعمرة.
When you go for Hajj and Umrah,
تسافر من بلد إلى بلد.
You travel from one country to another country.
تدفع المال الكثير.
And you pay a lot of money.
تزاحم هناك.
And you get pushed around.
وتتعرض للمخاطر.
And you get difficulty within your path.
اصبر.
And you've got to be patient.
الدعوة إلى الله.
And when you call to Allah,
ربما يسبونك.
And they may swear at you.
ربما يطردونك.
They may take you out of your city.
اصبر.
You've got to be patient for Allah.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قالوا ساحر.
They called him a magician.
قالوا كاهن.
They called him a liar.
قالوا كذاب.
They called him a liar.
شجوا رأسه.
And they hit his head and made it bleed.
أدموا وجنته. أصابوا وجنته بالدم.
And they caused harm to his cheek and face.
كسروا رباعيته.
And they broke his teeth.
طردوه من أرضه.
And they took him out of the city.
صبر.
But he was patient.
حتى نصره الله.
Until Allah Azza wa Jal gave him victory.
فدين الله كله قائم على الصبر.
All of the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal is based upon patience.
في تعلمه.
When you learn the deen of Allah.
في العمل به.
When you act upon the deen of Allah.
في الدعوة إليه.
When you call to the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal.
لا بد من الصبر في هذا.
You must have patience in all of these three categories.
ولذلك قال في سورة العصر.
And Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Al-Asr.
و والعصر أي في الزمان الليل والنهار.
And Allah Azza wa Jalla swears by the time of Asr, meaning the time of Asr that which we have.
إن الإنسان لفي خسر أي indeed, الناس خاسرون.
Indeed, every human being is in loss.
إلا
except
اختار الله أنتم اختاركم الله إلا.
And Allah Azza wa Jalla has chosen you.
الذين آمنوا.
The ones who believe in Allah.
أي عرفوا الله حق المعرفة.
And they have understood Allah Azza wa Jalla.
وعملوا.
And they act upon that which is given to them by Allah.
وتواصوا بالحق أي دعوا إلى الله.
And then they call the people to that which is the deen of Allah.
وانظر في الآية.
And then look into the ayah.
لم يقل وأوصوا بالحق.
And he did not say, I advise you to hold on or advise you to call to the deen of Allah.
كأنها مرة واحدة.
And he says, oh, it's once.
لا. قال وتواصوا أي أن الدعوة إلى الله مستمرة.
And he said, وتواصوا, I keep on going, calling, keep on calling people to the deen of Allah.
وتواصوا بالصبر أي دائما نحن يوصي بعضنا بعضا بالصبر.
And again, keep on reminding one another of patience.
كما في آية آل عمران.
And as it said in آل عمران.
وصابروا.
And be patient.
أي حث بعضكم بعضا على الصبر.
And also encourage one another to be patient.
فنحن إخوة.
And we are brothers.
ننسى.
We sometimes forget.
يضعف إيماننا.
Sometimes the إيمان goes weak.
نصاب بالكسل.
Sometimes laziness overcomes us.
إذا تركتوني.
If you were to leave me.
سوف أضيع.
I will lose myself.
وأترك الإسلام.
I may leave Islam.
لا تتركوني.
So don't leave your brothers.
أوصوني.
You give them advice.
كل منا يوصي الثاني.
And you remind one another.
من تأخر عن الصلاة نوصيه بالصلاة.
And whoever delays his salah, we remind him that he needs to pray on time.
من تأخر عن العلم نوصيه بالعلم.
Whoever moves away from knowledge, we remind him the fact that he needs to learn his knowledge.
من تأخر عن بر الوالدين نوصيه بر الوالدين.
Whoever moves away from being obedient to his parents, we remind him that he needs to be obedient.
والصبر على ذلك.
And we need to be patient with that.
فهذا معنى وتواصوا بالصبر.
And this is what it means to be patient.
أسأل الله الكريم رب العرش العظيم أن يوفقنا وإياكم للعلم النافع. والعمل الصالح.
I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to grant you all knowledge that which is sound and actions that which are accepted.
ونكتفي بهذا القدر من الكتاب ونتفرغ للأسئلة حتى يأتي الإفطار.
Inshallah, we will stop at the book at this moment, and inshallah continue with it tomorrow. And inshallah, we will take any questions if anyone has any.
نعم من عنده سؤال يسأل إما مكتوب.
Shall I go then? We start 9:30.
كم باقي على ذا؟
9:30 نبدأ غدا. لا غدا متى نبدأ تسعة خلينا الساعة تاسعة
تسعة ونص
إن شاء الله tomorrow's درس we will start 9:30 إن شاء الله
احرصوا على الحضور غدا
مبكرا the issue is we want the brothers to attend
التاسعة والنصف
so 9:30
نستفيد إن شاء الله خيرا كثيرا
and we will benefit إن شاء الله
نعم
إن شاء الله we would prefer that the brothers come on time إن شاء الله any questions
شفهي للصيام ولغير الصيام للتوحيد.
Any questions at all whether it's with the topic or outside of the topic anything at all
نعم تفضل استريح استريح
عليكم السلام What are the attributes of Allah يسأل السائل أن ما هي صفات الله عز وجل
طيب الله عز وجل
الله عز وجل
أخبرنا عن صفاته في القرآن الكريم
He has mentioned his attributes in the Quran
من أعظم صفات الله
From the greatest attribute Allah عز وجل has mentioned
أنه رب العالمين
That he is the Lord of the worlds
هو الذي خلقنا
He is the one to create us
هذا الكون العظيم
All of this that you see around you
دليل على الله
This is evidence of Allah عز وجل.
يقول عز وجل إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات.
And Allah عز وجل says, indeed in the creation of the heavens and the earth and the night and the day there is signs.
فمن صفات الله عز وجل أنه رب العالمين أي خالق الخلق أجمعين.
So from the attributes of Allah عز وجل that He is the Lord of the worlds.
ولذلك لما قال فرعون لموسى من ربكما يا موسى؟
And when it was said to Fir'aun, who is your Lord? When Fir'aun said to Musa عليه السلام, who is your Lord?
ربنا الله الذي أعطى كل شيء خلقه يعني الذي خلقك الله.
And he answered to him, it's Allah عز وجل who created everything.
كل شيء خلقه الله.
Everything created, everything is created by Allah.
هذا الكون لا بد له من خالق.
And there's no doubt the fact that to everything that there is around us, there needs to be a creator for it. And we should worship that creator who's created everything. And this world is surprising.
فيه أسرار وفيه عجائب.
There are secrets and there are surprises within it.
أنت بنفسك فيك عجائب.
And you within yourself is an amazing creation from Allah Azza wa Jal.
كم عمرك؟
How old are you?
52. 52 سنة. قلبك يتحرك.
He goes, your heart is beating.
هل هناك بطارية؟
Is there any batteries within that?
كهرباء.
Is there any electricity in that?
من يحركها؟
Who is the one that's moving it?
الله عز وجل.
It's Allah عز وجل that's commanded it.
أنا أعبد الله الذي حرك قلبي.
And I worship the one who's moving my heart.
وحرك قلوب العالمين.
And he's moving the heart of the worlds.
وخلق الكون أجمع.
And he's the one who created everything.
هذا الذي أعبده.
This is the one I worship.
أيضا من صفات الله الإلوهية أنه الله اسمه الله أي المعبود.
And from the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal is the fact that He is worthy of worship.
ولا يسمى بهذا الاسم إلا الله.
And there is no one that has the right to be named as such except from Allah.
فمعنى الله أي المعبود.
So what does the word Allah means? It means the one who's worshipped.
فهو الذي نعبده ولا نعبد غيره.
And He is the one that we worship and we don't worship anyone else.
من صفات الله أنه سميع.
And from the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal is the fact that He's all-hearing.
يسمع الكلام.
He hears your words.
ولو كان منخفضا.
Even if they are low in voice.
كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جالس في الحجرة.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was within his room.
وبجواره امرأة.
And there was next door to him a woman.
عندها مشكلة مع زوجها.
And that woman had a problem with her husband.
وتكلم النبي سرا.
And And the woman was speaking to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam quietly.
وعائشة في الطرف الآخر من الحجرة.
And عائشة رضي الله عنها was in the other side of the room.
تقول أنا لا أسمع.
And عائشة رضي الله عنها she says and I couldn't hear what the woman was saying to the Prophet.
فأنزل الله.
And then Allah عز وجل revealed.
قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك.
Indeed Allah عز وجل has heard the words of the woman that she's saying to the Prophet.
فربك يسمع.
And it's Allah Azza wa Jal that he's all hearing.
بصير, يراك.
Allah Azza wa Jal is all seeing and he sees you.
ويرى الخلق أجمعين.
And he sees the whole world together.
الله عليم.
Allah Azza wa Jal is all knowing.
يعلم ما تخفي الصدور.
And he knows that which is hidden with inside your hearts.
ويعلم ما كان.
And he knows that which was before.
ويعلم ما سيكون.
And Allah Azza wa Jal knows what will happen in the future.
إذا أردت أن تعرف الله.
If you wish to know Allah Azza wa Jal.
فقرأ كتاب الله.
Then read the book of Allah.
هذا الكتاب.
And this book,
الله أرسله لك.
Allah Azza wa Jal has sent it for you.
ولي.
And He has sent it for me.
ولنا.
And He has sent it for us.
وللأولين.
And He has sent it for the ones before us.
وللآخرين.
And He has sent it for the ones who will come after us.
اعرف رسالة الله.
So know Allah Azza wa Jal through this book.
لن تعرف الله حتى تقرأ كتاب.
You will never get to know Allah Azza wa Jal if you don't study the Quran.
ستجد أسماء الله.
And you will find the names of Allah Azza wa Jal.
وكلما مريت باسم من مررت باسم من أسماء الله فاعرف معناه.
And every time you go past the name of Allah Azza wa Jal, learn it and comprehend it and ponder over it.
نعم.
Any other questions?
لو في الصيام لا بأس.
Even if it's in Siyam, any other issues that are related to the people, this is a chance for yourselves, and it's not a chance that is every day to come. So any questions at all?
نعم مسألة هذه يسأل سؤال هل الصيام شرط في الاعتكاف؟
The question that was proposed, the fact that if a person wishes to do اعتكاف, is it a must the fact that he fasts?
يعني هل يصح الاعتكاف في غير رمضان؟
Is it permissible to do اعتكاف other than in the month of Ramadan?
مثلا يوم إجازة يوم السبت أريد أن أعتكف في المسجد من الفجر إلى المغرب.
For example, it's today's Saturday. The fact that I wish to come to the masjid and wish to do اعتكاف.
وأنا غير صائم.
And I'm not fasting.
نعم يجوز ذلك.
He goes, the Sheikh says yes, this is permissible.
لأن رجلا سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
A man asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وقال إني نذرت أن أعتكف ليلة.
Indeed, I have vowed Allah Azza wa Jal that I will do i'tikaf of one night.
والليل ليس فيه صيام.
And in the night there is not any fasting.
فقام سلم أوفي بنذرك.
And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fulfill your vow to Allah.
فيجوز الاعتكاف بالصيام أو بغير الصيام.
And so it's permissible to do i'tikaf fasting or not fasting in both ways.
وأفضله بصيام في رمضان في العشر الأواخر.
And the best is the fact that the person does i'tikaf in the month of Ramadan whilst he's fasting.
نعم.
في شهر رمضان ويريد أن يعتكف؟
لا بأس. من كان مريضا وقد أحل الله له الفطر.
And the one who is sick and Allah Azza wa Jal has permitted for him that he breaks his fast.
ولكنه رغب في الاعتكاف.
But he is interested in doing اعتكاف.
لا بأس.
And there is no problem in that.
أن يعتكف وأن يفطر.
And the fact that he could do اعتكاف and he could break his fast due to his sickness.
نعم. نعم المقصود الاعتكاف إن شاء الله مقبل هذه الأيام.
اعتكاف is to come within these days, which is tomorrow.
ومن أراد الاعتكاف ينبغي أن يجعل القصد من اعتكافه التفرغ للعبادة.
And the one who intends to do اعتكاف in the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan, then it is upon him the fact that he frees himself from the worldly things.
يشتغل بالقرآن.
And he should engage in reciting the Quran.
بالذكر.
He should engage himself in remembering Allah.
بالصلاة.
He should engage in trying to do his salah.
ولا يشتغل بغيره من.
And he should not engage himself in anything else other than that.
وإذا أراد أن يتحدث مع صاحبه بكلام مباح بشيء قليل لا بأس.
And if he wishes to talk to his friend or someone in something that which is small and that which is permissible, then there's no problem in that.
وكذلك الجوال.
And also with inside your phone.
ولكن لا يشغل وقته به.
And he should not engage in wasting his time with the phone.
أو يزعج غيره.
Or he should disturb other people through it.
وإنما تتكلم بالكلام الذي لا يزعج الآخرين.
Rather he should just keep it to the extent to what is needed for himself.
وبقدر قليل.
Without disturbing anyone and keeping it very limited.
كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحدث مع زوجاته في اعتكافه.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would speak to his wives. In duration of his اعتكاف.
بشيء قليل.
And it would be very limited.
فالمقصود أنه ينبغي في وقت الاعتكاف أن نتفرغ للعبادة.
So what's needed is the fact that the person frees himself in the month in the last 10 days of اعتكاف.
ولا نزعج غيرنا.
And he does not disturb anyone, engages himself in worshiping Allah.
لا بصوت.
And he does not disturb anyone with his voice.
أو بمحادثة.
Or with any conversation with any other people.
أو بأعمال فنزعج المصلين.
Or to do actions that which would cause disturbance.
وإنما نخفض أصواتنا.
Rather we should lower our voices.
ونقلل من التواصل مع الناس لأن القصد من الاعتكاف التفرغ للعبادة.
And we should limit our engagement with people due to the fact that we are freeing ourselves for the purpose of worship.
نعم. تفضل أخوي تفضل حياك الله. نعم.
القرآن الكريم أو السور الموجودة في القرآن الكريم تبدأ باسم الله الرحمن
الرحيم.
ولكن القرآن الكريم حدثنا بأنه في سورة النمل سيدنا سليمان قال من أبعث رسالة إلى
وأنهم نعم.
ملك السلام قال بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
نعم.
وهذه قبل
نعم. نعم. قال بسم الله مجريها.
قال بسم الله مسرها ومجراها.
نعم.
ليه سيدنا نوح لم يكمل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم؟ ومن أين جاءت هذه
التسمية؟ أي طيب. ما يسأل هو الترجم. الأخ يسأل عن البسملة.
The brother is asking in regards to the ruling of Bismillah.
وأن القرآن مبدوء بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
And the fact that the Quran has been introduced with the words of Allah Bismillah.
وقد ذكر الله تعالى بأن سليمان لما أرسل رسالة إلى ملكة سبأ.
And Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in the Quran when Sulaiman عليه السلام sent a letter to Sabah.
ذكروا أنه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أي أنه مبدوء بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
And within that letter it's indicated the fact that it started in the name of Allah Azza wa Jal.
فالبسمة الأنبياء على الأنبياء كلهم من الله عز وجل.
All of the prophets are from Allah Azza wa Jal.
والبسمة عند كل الأنبياء.
And to say Bismillah to start in the name of Allah Azza wa Jal was with all the prophets.
ليست خاصة بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا بأمته.
And this is not specifically only for the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم or for his nation.
وكما ترون قالها محمد عليه السلام.
And as you see, the fact the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says.
وقالها سليمان.
And Sulaiman says.
وقالها كذلك نوح عليه السلام.
And also نوح عليه السلام said the same.
وفي نطق البسملة تأتي أحيانا. بسم الله فقط
upon pronouncing the words Bismillah, you would find upon your tongue.
وأحيانا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
And you will find to say بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
في الخطابات والكتب. في الخطابات والكتب فقط.
And you would find that within books and within sermons.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
The complete sentence بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
أما في الأعمال.
And as it is for actions and doing things.
فبسم الله فقط.
You only say بسم الله.
الأكل.
When it comes to eating,
نقول بسم الله.
You say بسم الله.
الدخول المسجد.
When you come into the masjid,
نقول بسم الله.
You say بسم الله.
الأعمال عامة نقول بسم الله.
Any action that you do, you say بسم الله upon it.
نوح عليه السلام كان يقوم بعمل.
نوح عليه السلام was carrying out a certain act.
فقال بسم الله.
And he said بسم الله.
عند الذبيحة.
And when he would slaughter.
نقول بسم الله.
It was said بسم الله.
فهذه بسملة تكون عند الأعمال.
And this بسم الله, we say it just بسم الله on its own upon actions and things that we do regularly.
أما عند الأقوال.
And when it comes to sayings.
والكتب.
And when it comes to books.
فنقول بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
And when it comes to sermons, we say بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
نعم.
Just the youth, if there's any questions, anything at all in regards to marriage, in regards to personal issues, anything at all. You could send out papers, write them down, send me a wee text or something. I'm welcome to take them.
No.
Ismail.
كم باقي؟ خلاص؟ انتهينا؟ لا خلاص نختم. طيب نختم بسؤال الأخ لأنه طلب. نعم.
الأمور التي واحد يفتى بها الصوم مثلا
بالتمر بالرطب
أي
يعني في ينقض الصيام. يقول الله تعالى يدع
غير الأكل والطعام.
أيوة الجماع, الرجل مع المرأة الجماع هذا يفطره, كذلك يفطر الإنسان الحجامة فقط.
Other than eating and drinking, which breaks your fast, if you were to have relations with your wife, that also would break one's fast. Also to do cupping, which is to take out blood from yourselves, but also break one's fast.
ونزول الشهوة.
And also جبري.
يعني من رجل نعم تعمد يعني بعمد.
If one was to masturbate, that would also break one's fast.
بعمد. أما.
And that is deliberate masturbation.
أما في النوم واحتلام لا.
If one is asleep or one is has a wet dream or something like that, then that does not break one's fast.
الاستقاء يتعمد يدخل أصبعه ثم يستقي.
And also to vomit deliberately, to put a finger down your throat to vomit, that would break one's fast.
أما إذا غلبه القيء واستقى وخرج منه القيء لا بأس.
But if he vomits naturally without any reason, then that does not break his fast.
الكفر بعد الإسلام.
Also to disbelieve after you have entered into Islam would also break your fast.
يبطل الصوم. والمرأة والحيض والنفاس.
And also a woman that enters into our
هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد. Next day إن شاء الله.
So
جزاكم الخير بسم الله استعن بالله.
But I just remind the brothers that we are going through the book, The Three Principles of Islam, or the three things that Muslim must know. And this dars will be going on for the rest of the week. And the dars will start at 9:15. And the official dars will start at 9:30, inshallah. So we request that the brothers as well as the sisters attend at 9:30 to benefit completely from the dars, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum.